Good morning to all grade 10 students of Pablo S. Villaverde High School. Again, this is your science teacher, Sir Eduardo D. Malie Jr. Today, we are going to tackle the quarter 2, module 2. Our topic is all about electromagnetic wave equation. Okay, our most essential learning competency is compare the relative wavelengths of different forms of electromagnetic waves. To start with our discussion in electromagnetic wave equation, the world of electromagnetics can be better understood if we will be exposed to electromagnetic wave equations, meaning we are going to solve some problem involving electromagnetic wave equation, wherein it describes the relationship between frequency and wavelengths of electromagnetic waves. So in this module, you will learn about the different types of electromagnetic waves, the relationship between frequency and wavelengths, as well as computing the frequency and wavelength of a wave. And for our targets in this module, at the end of the module, you should be able to, number one, explain the relationship between wavelength and frequency of a wave. And number two, compute for the frequency and wavelength of a wave. Before we proceed to the different activities in this module, we are going to answer this pretest or under the try this. So in our directions, identify what is asked or described in each item. Then write the letter of the correct answer in your answer sheet. So as my first suggestion in my students, you are going to use the activity notebook. Okay, number one, which of the following correctly describes the relationship between speed, wavelength, and frequency of a wave? Letter A, speed is equal to the wavelength plus frequency. Letter B, speed is equal to wavelength divided by frequency. Letter C, speed is equal to wavelength multiplied by frequency. Letter D, speed is equal to frequency divided by wavelength. And in number two, electromagnetic waves with higher frequency have wavelengths that are letter A, shorter, B, longer, C, the same, D, cannot be determined. And number three, what happens to wavelength when frequency of a wave increases? Letter A, increases. Letter B, decreases. C, remains the same. D, cannot be determined. And number four, which of the following could a wave with highest frequency has? Letter A, longest wavelength. Letter B, shortest wavelength. Letter C, lowest energy. Letter D, low frequency. And number five, what is the wavelength of radio waves with frequency of 675 kilohertz? Letter A, 280 meters. Letter B, 324 meters. Letter C, 400 meters. And letter D, 444 meters. Okay, let us now proceed to the first activity entitled the crossword puzzle game. In our direction, complete the crossword puzzle below by filling in a word that fits each clue. Okay, we have the across and then down direction. So under the across, we have 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, and 11. And in down direction, we have 2, 3, 8. So let us now read the content. Okay, number one, one half of the height from the peak of the crest to the lowest point of a wave. And number four, unit of frequency of electromagnetic wave. And number five, a space where electromagnetic waves can travel. And number six, lowest part of a wave. And number seven, highest part of a wave. Number nine, electromagnetic waves with high energy. Number 10, distance measured from one crest to the next crest of a wave or from one trough to second trough. Number 11, number of cycles a wave completes in 1 second. Okay, in down direction, we have number 2, unit of wavelength of electromagnetic wave. And number 3, a disturbance in a field that carries energy but does not require a medium to travel. And in number 8, electromagnetic waves with lowest frequency. And as we go further with this discussion, you can be able to answer all this necessary information in our crossword puzzle game. To explore, our activity title is Complete Me. How do frequencies of electromagnetic waves compare? So in this table, you are going to use the basic information, the velocity of electromagnetic waves, which is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. And then the equation that C is equals to frequency times the wavelength to find the wavelength, the frequency of each type of wave. But I am suggesting that you have to continue watching this video because I have actual explanation in some of the problems here in page 7 where you'll be able to complete all the necessary information by computing the frequency and then the wavelength. Okay, let us now proceed first to this page 6. Okay, radio waves. Look at this figure. As you can see from left to right, we have radio waves, microwaves, infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, x-rays, and gamma rays. And in the next module, we are going to explain deeper or in detail all about the members of this electromagnetic spectrum. So, magnetic waves can be described by their wavelengths, energy, and frequency. All three describe a different property of light, yet they are related to each other mathematically. The two equations below show the relationship. Okay, in equation 1, look at this one. We have the F and lambda. Okay, this is not H. This symbol is lambda or represent the wavelength. And F represent the frequency. And then the C, the speed of light or speed of electromagnetic wave, which has the constant value of 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. And then in this equation, E, energy is equals to Planck's constant times frequency. The wavelength of an electromagnetic wave is the distance between wave crest. Other property used to describe every wave. Okay, when I say crest, this is the highest part of the wave. And to the another highest part of the wave, that is the so-called wavelength or the length or how long the wave is. Or we can also say that wavelength is from trough, the lowest point, to another trough. So from trough to trough, that is one wavelength. Or from crest to crest, that is one wavelength. When we say the highest peak, this is the so-called the crest. Lowest part is the so-called the trough. And when we say amplitude, or the half of the lowest point to the highest point, or from this line, as you can see this line, this is the so-called the equilibrium position. The equilibrium position, or from the equilibrium position to the highest point or to the crest, is the so-called amplitude. So the size of the distance between wave crest is measured in terms of micrometer or micron. The unit is this. This is micron. The size of the wavelengths of radiation range from ultra-long radio waves to high-energy gamma rays. The amount, okay, keep this one, these bold letters in your mind. The amount of energy in the wave increases as wavelengths get smaller and tighter. Or the energy of the wave increases, meaning the wavelength decreases or getting smaller. When radiation is measured using very sensitive instruments at extremely low light level, it is observed that the energy does not arrive continuously in waves, but rather in small, finite amounts. This is the particle view of radiation. Particles view of light are called photons. Radiation can also be thought of as a collection of photons, the tiny but discrete packets of energy traveling at the speed of light. Low energy photons tend to behave more like waves, while higher energy photons, example the X-rays, behave more like particles. So even though X-rays and gamma rays are part of the electromagnetic spectrum, scientists generally refer to them by describing their energies rather than their wavelengths. In satellite meteorology, we are concerned with radiant energy with wavelengths between 0.1 and 100 micron. The sun, for example, emits most of its radiant energy with a wavelength between 0.2 to 4 micron. The solar energy, frequently referred to as shortwave radiation, remember where it is on the spectrum, includes ultraviolet, visible, and near-infrared radiation. And let us now proceed to the sample problem. Okay, our sample problem, assume that waves propagate in vacuum, meaning the constant velocity of light that we are going to use, or the constant velocity of electromagnetic wave that we are going to use, is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second, this value, this one. So here is my explanation how I in these answers. Okay, watch this.
Today I am going to explain the sample problems in page 7 of your quarter 2 module 2. Okay, the problems are: what is the frequency of radio waves in wavelength of 20 meters? And the number 2 problem in page 7 is: what is the wavelength of light waves with frequency of 6 times 10 raised to 14 hertz? But before we can compute that, I'm going to teach you first how are we going to derive the different formulas. So let us now proceed to the formula derivation. Formula is C is equals to F times wavelength. This is not H, this is lambda, or the symbol of wavelength. Okay, the C stands for the velocity of light or the electromagnetic wave. And The value of that C is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. And then F stands for frequency. And then this symbol is lambda or the wavelength. Now we are going to find the formula for frequency. So we are going to use this basic formula that C is equals to F times or the frequency times wavelength. So using the reflexive property of equality, we are going to transform the position. F or the frequency times wavelength is equals to C. And then we are going to divide both sides by the wavelength. So dividing both sides by wavelength, we can now cancel out the wavelength here. So we have now the formula F is equals to C divided by wavelength or the frequency. Okay, finding formula for wavelength. Okay, the same, we are going to use this basic formula. And then we are going to use again that reflexive property of equality. And then dividing both sides by frequency, we have now wavelength is equals to C divided by F. So we have now formula. In problem number one, what is the frequency of radio waves with wavelength of 20 meters? Before we can solve any problem, we are going first to find for the given. What are given? So the given are the wavelength is equivalent to 20 meters. Okay, let us remember that the standard unit for wavelength is meter. So if that is not meter, if this is in kilometer, you are going to convert that first in meter. And then the C, that is the constant value of the velocity of electromagnetic waves, 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So the formula that we are going to use based on the derived formula, frequency is equal to speed of electromagnetic wave divided by the wavelength. So substituting now the formula, the value of C is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second, and then the value of wavelength is 20 meters. We can now cancel out this unit. Therefore, what unit will be remain is the per second. When we say 1 over per second, that is equivalent to hertz or the unit of frequency. So, frequency that we are going to use now is the hertz. So, let us now divide. 3 divided by 20. So, the result is 0.15. So, we are just going to copy the scientific notation times 10 raised to 8 hertz. Remember that in scientific notation, number. So we are, by adjusting 1 from left to the right, we are going to deduct 1 exponent because we move from left to right. So it becomes from 0.15 becomes 1.5 times 10 raised to 7 minus 1 exponent from the original 8. So the result is 1.5 times 10 raised to 7 hertz. Keep on keeping your mind that hertz is equals to 1 per second. Okay, in number 2, the wavelength of light waves with a frequency of 6 times 10 raised to 14 hertz. Okay, again, we are going to find for the given. The given are frequency, 6 times 10 raised to 14 hertz. The constant given is the speed of electromagnetic spectrum, 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So, what is asked is the wavelength. So, let us remember that the unit of wavelength should be in meter. So, this is now the formula or the solution. Wavelength is equals to C divided by frequency. So, substituting now the formula, 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second, which is the value of C, and then the value of F over F, 6 times 10 raised to 14 per second. So, before we proceed to the final answer, let us now discuss how it comes that the second were canceled. Okay, we're going to change the format. So, 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. We're just going to change the format. Meter per second. That is also equivalent to 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Divided by 6 times 10 raised to 14 per second. Therefore, the denominator in this equation is the second in this denominator. In this denominator, it has another denominator. Meaning, we're going to convert to dividing fraction. So this is now the equivalent. So 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second divided by 6 times 10 raised to 14 per second as equivalent to this from the original unit of hertz. So applying the rules in dividing fraction, when we divide fraction, we are going to get the reciprocal of the divisor and proceed to the rules of multiplication. So we are now going to multiply. So based on this equation, we can now cancel out second and second, remaining the unit m. So therefore, we can now consider that 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter divided by 6 times 10 raised to 14 equivalent to this. That's why we can cancel the second. So let us now proceed to the answer. 3 divided by 6, the result is 0.5. So 0.5 times 10, why is it becomes negative 6? When dividing number with involving exponent, we are going to subtract the exponent. So 8 minus 14, that is negative 6. So again, we are going to round it off, or to the final answer, we hope we should have, in expressing scientific notation, we should have whole number. So we are going to move 1 to the right. Again, we are going to minus 1. So 5 times 10, negative 6 minus 1, that is negative 7. So the result of the wavelength is 5 times 10 raised to 7 meter. Okay. By means of this sample, you can now complete the table.
Okay. After watching my explanation, I'm pretty sure that you can now answer this, apply what you have learned. For your information, you are not going to choose letters here, but instead you are going to solve this A problem and B problem under number 1 and A problem and B problem under number 2. You are not going to choose letter A, letter B, no. And number 1, what is the frequency of electromagnetic wave, electromagnetic with a wavelength of, meaning you are going to solve letter A, 1 times 10 raised to negative 3 meter. Letter B given, 3.8 times 10 raised to negative 7. So, and under number 1, 2 problems. And under number 2, we are going to compute the wavelength. So, another 2 problems in number 2. And in guide questions, in problem number 1, how do varying wavelengths affect the frequency of a wave? So, you can answer this number 1 after solving the 2 problems in number 1. And also in number 2, in problem number 2, how do varying frequencies affect the wavelength of a wave? So you can answer this correctly if you are going to find or solve the problems here in letter A and letter B. So, for us to reflect, you are going to write, I have learned that. Or you may comment down here your learnings in comment box. So, I'm going to read all your comments, especially to my students. I'm going to respond to your comments or to your question I wish to ask my teacher about. So you can write questions regarding this topic. So for the reinforcement, are infrared, microwave, and radio waves harmful to us? You may answer yes or no, but depend your answer by giving your reasons. And in our vocabulary, the following terms used in this module are defined as follows. Amplitude, one half of the height from the peak of a crest to the lowest point of a wave. Electromagnetic wave, a disturbance in a field that carries energy and does not require a medium to travel. Frequency, number of cycles of a wave completes in 1 second, expressed in hertz or 1 per second. Hertz, date used to measure the frequency of waves. Wave, a disturbance that transfers energy. Wavelength, the distance measured from one crest of a wave to the next crest or from one trough to the second trough. Okay, let us now proceed to the assessment. Let us assess what you have learned. Okay, in your activity notebook again, you are going to answer this 1 to 5 assessment question. Okay, number 1, what is the frequency of a radio wave with a wavelength of 2.2 meters? So you are going to solve here in number 1. Letter A, 3 times 10 raised to 8 hertz. Letter B, 1.36 times 10 raised to 8 Hertz. Letter C, 7.3 times 10 raised to negative 9 Hertz. Letter D, 2.2 times 10 raised to 8 Hertz. And number 2, what happens to the wavelength of a wave if frequency is doubled? Letter A, the same. Letter B, doubled. Letter C, half. Letter D, cannot be determined. And number 3, which of the following EM waves carries more energy than the others? A, microwaves. B, radio waves. C, UV rays. D, visible light. Number 4. What can electromagnetic waves travel through that mechanical waves cannot? Letter A, air. B, wood. Letter C, water. D, vacuum. Number 5. What is the relationship between wavelength and frequency? A, there is an equal value of frequency and wavelength of electromagnetic waves. B, there is a direct relationship between the frequency and wavelength of electromagnetic waves. Letter C, there is an inverse relationship between the frequency and wavelength of electromagnetic waves. And letter D, cannot be determined. Okay, the next video lesson that I'm going to upload is the module 3 of quarter 2, wherein we are going to tackle more on the detailed information of magnetic spectrum family. I hope you enjoy my video and you learn a lot from this video lesson. Again, this is Sir Eduardo D. Mali Jr. Thank you for watching.